Another complexion product. Oh my god, this is disgusting.
Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to do a Predict Pan introduction, and this is the finished 20 in 2020. Last year I did the 19 in 2019 and I really enjoyed it, and I was really considering just doing 10 in 2020, like half of the people in the padding community, but I'm insane, so I'm doing 20 in 20. I thought it was going to be a good idea to do half-half. So in this project, I'm doing 10 beauty items and 10 makeup items, and I have tried to be realistic. Most of these items I really want to finish in this year, so let's see if I can do it. The items that I need to mark on a paper, I will do that after this I have filmed, and I will take some pictures afterwards and so on. I will explain more when I come to the product. The first product that I want to finish this year is my MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in NW15. I had this in my graveyard project pan and I got very far, so I really want to finish off the last small bit that I have. And I am working on another concealer right now that is reminding me of this, but I don't think that is going to last a very long time this year, so I thought why not try to finish the last small bit of this. I'm at where it says Pro Longwear on the bottle, so I will write that down and hopefully I can remember that by next update, because I have heard MAC is very iffy about us writing on the packaging. Maybe I will just take a picture. Will that be easier? I think so. I have a foundation. It is the W7 Very Vegan HD Foundation in Sand Beige. This is where I am of the product. I'm just above where it says Very, and I think that is almost halfway, so I don't think this is a problem finishing off this year. I do think it is a darker shade that I am right now, so this is better in the summertime. But I can definitely do that. This is not a problem. I just need to be the right skin tone. The next item I have is a cream blush, and this is from the Bon Jovi Rockstar palette, and it is a cream blush / a lip product. You can use it as both. It is a red shade, and on my complexion, it is so bright. I don't have it on today. I don't know what I did. This is very, very bright, and yeah. I have been using this solidly for like half a year, and I have a massive dip in it, and I have quite a good pan. As you can see, it is very red and very dirty. I will do my best to give you a swatch that is... Oh my god. This is not blended out, obviously, but I'm going to try to finish this off next year because I don't want any cream blushes in my life anymore. This got to go, and it's not very big. I don't know how big it is, but it is going to go. It needs to go. Then we have this product. This is the NYX Powder Blush in Taupe. It is an old packaging. I have a good dip in it, and I really want to finish this year. This needs to go. I bought this when I lived in Germany in 2015/2016. This needs to go. It is so old. I don't use contour enough. I have almost worn down the bricks. It's not called that. I don't know what they're called. But as you may can see, it is very, very flat here. It is only here that you can feel the grit. No, it's not called that. I have no idea what it's called, but I want to finish it. Goal by next update is to wear down it even more. This powder is a little bit tricky because I have not franken it like I want to. I want to franken it anymore, so it's not where I want it to be by the intro, but I just haven't had time. So much for an excuse. This is a franken bronzer with a manicotti mini bronzer duo and some of Wet n Wild bronzer, and then I want to franken more of that in, plus
the rest of the Hoola bronzer from Benefit, because this is a little bit too dark and too shimmery, so I thought more matte light bronzers got into this and I can use it. Does that make sense? The small Manakadar duo bronzer eyeshadow thing was very dark and very shimmery, and I don't like that in a bronzer, and I have 1,010,000 bronzy eyeshadows. So, need to fine-tune this more. The next thing I want to talk about is the W7 Eye Dream Shadow Cream in Heavy Metal. This is a purpley cream shadow. I am more than halfway done with this product. I can see some windows down to half of the product, but I know it's a little bit below. So I thought, why not just finish this and get another cream shadow out of your collection? So I'm going to work on this. An eye primer that I want to finish this year is the W7 I Got The Power All Day Wear Primer. This is how it is looking like. And as you can see, I'm a little bit more than halfway done with this product, so I think I can finish it this year. Just need to pull my shit together. But I really want to finish it this year, and I think I can do it. An eyeliner that I want to finish is the P2 Impressive Gel Kajal in Dramatic Blue. This is a twist up eyeliner just the way I like them. It is a navy blue color, and it is almost brand new. This is how it is looking like. I don't think it is going to match the green that I really want to finish up, but I really want this to be done and out of my life. I don't use it enough. Another product that I really want gone, that I don't use, and I don't see why it is still here in my collection, it is the W7 Double Prime Lips and Brows Duo Primer. This I had in my whole collection project pan last year. And this is how much I have left. It is broken. It broke on me. It is all the way up here. So is that a good reference, maybe? I wouldn't consider this much, but and it is working. I do really like the product. I just don't gravitate towards a lip primer. And for a panner, a lip primer is not a good thing. Just saying. This product though is not entirely makeup, but it's not body care as well, or either. This is the W7 Life's a Beach Beach Body Contour Sculpting Body Cream. I panned one of the... Hello. Felix? Hello. This is not moisturizing. It is extremely glittery, so I think this is going to be a nice color for me in the summertime. I panned one last year that was on the lighter side, even though I am extremely pale. Oh my god. Life. So it is almost brand new, I think. Yeah, it is brand new. It is up to here or something. This is in the color Golden Goddess. This is the middle shade of the shade range, if you can say like that. Panned the light shade last year, so let's take the next. I am excited to see how this works out for me when I get a tan, because I really liked it in the summertime. I just need to pull myself together and use this product. I have one more though. Oh my god. This one. This is the W7 Jelly Crush Lip Scrub in Juicy Blast Berry. I have tried to use this up in the Food for Thought project pan, and I didn't go very far in that project. Oh. Let's just set a new goal and put it in a new project pan. Why not? I'm going to try to finish this year. I really want it gone, and I have other ones in this series, in others. Scents, smells, whatever you want to say. I want them gone because it's not that good. I want them gone. It does the job decently, but not good enough to buy them again. Last W7 product, shall we? Oh my god. This is the W7 Glow It All Multi-Glow Serum. I panned one of these last year. Yeah, in the springtime, I think. It was like a blue sheen. This has a pink sheen, as you may can see. So this is really exciting to be working on, I think. I think it was beautiful, and it was dewy through the foundation and stuff like that. It's not moisturizing. It is up to here, so it is almost brand new. I have used it a handful of times, so I can go through these very quickly. I just need to do it and use it. I have the Pure and Care Volcanic Charcoal Mask. This one right here. I have a feeling that this is going bad. I'm not entirely sure because it is a little bit drier in the consistency than it was when I bought it. So I think it might be on its last leg. If you could see right here. It is almost just as at the edges, but I really want to finish this off this year and see if I want to have a clay mask or charcoal mask again. This is a good one though. It is affordable, but I just need to use this up to consider if I want to buy it again. I have a body lotion. It is a Franken body lotion. I have quite a few things in here, and this is all that I have left of it. It is down to here. So it was quite full at some point last year, and now it is all the way down to here. So I really want to finish this. This is all, I dump things in this when I can't get them out of the container anymore, or if I don't like the container. And I dumped a whole body lotion, a very big one, into this because I didn't like the packaging, and it has been working. And I've been using it. I just need to finish up the last bit. This is a product that is not this. It is a heat protection spray from Tresemme. I will insert a clip of the original bottle. I still have that because I'm weird. But the spray stopped working on the heat protection spray packaging. So I depotted or decanned it into this spray right here. Or something. So I just want to use it up because I don't use it enough. I don't curl or straighten my hair that much. This is me getting out of the shower yesterday. It's still completely flat. So I only straighten my hair if it is completely insane and I really want decent hair and I don't want to have it up and stuff like that. That's when I need to use this, but I don't. So I thought a product might be a good idea to put it in. The last five items are all from one brand. Everything comes from a gift box that I got last year. The only thing I have used up from that gift box was my micellar water that I have in my empties. You can check that out if you haven't. It is all from Nils Jord, which is a Danish brand. So I really wanted to try the skincare, so I asked for that gift box. And now it's time to use the shit up. Oh my god, I have had it for a year and I have only touched the face cream and the micellar water. Oh my god, I need to pull myself together. I have the face cream. It is just for normal skin. It is a heavier cream, so I use it at nighttime because it is just too heavy underneath my makeup in the morning time. And it doesn't sink in very fast in the skin and I don't have time to wait. I don't know where this is. I can't see through it. I will just weigh this or something. I don't know. I'm going to use this up this year and I just need to do it. I don't want it. I don't like it that much. It smells weird as well. I have a hand cream for the same box. It is up to here, so it is almost brand new. I've used it like a handful of times, but it is up to here, so I need to mark that afterwards. I have a small body lotion. I have thought about putting that into the Franken body lotion, just because, but it is a smaller sample up to here. Then we have the face scrub, which is even smaller, and it is only down to here. Oh my god, that is half full and I have not used it. That is not going to be a problem at all. And then we have a face serum, and it is almost... For some reason, I can't see through this one. It is a smaller size. There is 10 milliliters in this serum. 15 in the scrub. 30 in the body lotion. And 75 in the hand cream. And 50 milliliters in the face cream. And I have been using this for a few months now. That is everything for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys are just as excited as I am for this project. I've been looking forward to it for so long, and I have picked my items for so long, and it has been sitting here for so long just for me to sit down and film. And I'm finally here. I'm finally doing it. It is official. I'm trying to use these items up. Some of them are insane and some of them are rather easy, so I want it to be like a 50-50. So I hope you guys are going to follow along, and all my other project pans are going to be on my channel. I have some of them up already. I have some projects coming. I hope you guys are looking forward to that. I'm excited and extremely nervous if I can do well and tackling all of those products. I hope you guys enjoyed, and until my next one, please take care. Bye.